California was like this legendary paradise.
This was the folk rock special.
The Laurel Canyon became this heavenly place.
To be that close to the Sunset Strip, and yet you had a feel that you were in the country, it's beautiful.
Everything turn, turn, turn. There is a season, turn, turn.
Laurel Canyon, it's like an open ticket to a studio, to a record, to everything.
That's an incredible environment for a musician to be in.
I fell in love with it.
All the bands you think of is that California sound.
Buffalo Springfield.
My name is Neil Young.
The Beach Boys.
Hi, Brian Wilson.
The Mamas and Papas.
The Byrds.
They were all there.
This kind of thing could only happen in Laurel Canyon.
The music that came out of the Laurel Canyon scene was inspiring to my generation of musicians and songwriters.
You guys ready to go to the 60s?
You gotta go where you wanna go. Do what you wanna do.
It was a nice circle of really good artists thinking like, how can I make a record as good as that one?
This music shaped the second half of the 20th century.
We all listen to each other's records. You can see the cross-pollination.
The Beach Boys were
said to be responsible for Sgt. Pepper.
They were just the best. Imagine a band influencing the Beatles.
Everyone was writing together. You'd go over to someone's house and you always brought your guitar.
People would just knock on the door and go, hey, listen to this.
Brian lived right down the street from us. The whole living room was full of sand. She said, I know it's crazy, but he's writing some great songs. And he was writing Pet Sounds.
These records come all of a sudden like an avalanche, and there's nothing like them before.
Music happens at a particular moment in time, and it changes everything going forward.
The power of music is undeniable. I truly believe it can change the world.
This is where big dreamers went to.